What's going on, Gearberry here. In this video, I'm gonna give you a full Udemy solo ads training for 2021. Now, chances are you're watching this video because maybe you wanna start running solo ads, right? Which is a form of paid advertising. In this video, you're actually going to learn how the platform works on Udemy and what the most important tabs to focus on are. I've personally used Udemy for over a year now, and I've generated thousands of dollars running successful solo ads. And there's a lot of tabs that just aren't that important. I'm gonna share with you what the most important tabs are. I'm also gonna share how to find sellers on Udemy to actually place an ad, okay? Because again, there's specific places you can go on Udemy itself to find the right sellers to purchase from. And I'm also gonna share with you the exact process to place your first effective Udemy solo ad to get targeted traffic this week, okay? So if you have some money to run your first solo ad, stick with me in this video and follow along so you can place your first ad. Now, be sure to stay till the very end of the video, because towards the end of the video, you're actually gonna discover the exact criteria, okay, I use again and again to choose the best seller to buy from. There's hundreds of sellers on Udemy. I'm gonna share with you the exact criteria to virtually guarantee I get sales from that person, okay? So you definitely want to stick around, and you do not want to miss this.
But before that, if you want to learn online money-making methods, affiliate marketing, or how to create passive income, be sure to go down below, click the subscribe button and the notification bell so you're always notified of my latest video. Last, if you want to discover my number one recommended way to make money online, click the first link in the description to check it out. Without further ado, let's begin today's video.
Okay, so I'm on Udemy.com right now, and like I said, I've actually spent, you know, thousands of my own dollars on this, and I've generated thousands more. And you can see right here, okay, it's a little bit hard to see, but orders 116, okay? So just in this one account, I've had 116 orders. I've done this many times. Now, the very first thing you wanna do is realize that there's a lot of these tabs that just aren't important, okay? The main important ones that I would highly recommend you focus on are orders. Okay, you're gonna be able to see your active orders, your past orders, what progress the person you purchased from actually has. Messages, okay, if you go into messages, you can actually have a dialogue with the seller. And sometimes, you know, I actually will ask them questions before I place that solo ad, and it's very important to check your messages. Ad text, okay, if I open this up, this is where you can actually save certain swipes, certain emails that you wanna use as your future solo ads, okay? If you wanna use the same ones over and over, you can just save them here. This is a pretty important tab, you know, especially if you're gonna run a lot of solo ads. And then really the find sellers and the solo deals, okay? Those are the only really main tabs that you wanna focus on. Now, solo deals, it's basically a tab where it will show you deals that sellers have, okay? So sometimes they'll have like 10% off, or, you know, a cheaper rate if you purchase more, okay? So this person right here has for 54 cents per click, okay, a certain promotion right now. And so if you actually took him up on this, if you clicked on that person, you could run, you know, a solo ad. But again, this may not fit the good criteria. There's a lot of people that, you know, are just brand new on Udemy, and they'll sell you a solo ad, but they don't have a good track record and you don't really want to purchase from them. So I don't often use the solo deals. The main place that I go is the find sellers, okay? Now the find sellers tab, when you click that, it's gonna drop down all these different sellers. Now these are people you can actually purchase a solo ad from, okay? So this person right here. Now once you see this, you can actually see different information, okay? So for example, when you look at these people, this is the person's name, okay? This is a little bit of text about what they're offering, what quality of traffic. But one thing you really wanna keep in mind is these numbers here, okay? So basically right here, this is how much per click this person's charging, okay? Because when you run a solo ad, you're basically paying per click. If you want 200 clicks, okay, and it's a certain amount of money per click, that's what the total amount of money you're gonna owe that person to run that solo ad, okay? So another highly important piece of information, and this is going to come in handy again towards the end of the video when I share the exact criteria, is what percent of people that have bought from this seller have reported getting sales. Okay, so for this person right here, you can see that 49% rather. That means virtually half of the people that purchased from this Eric guy have gotten a sale. Okay, so don't you think that looking at that information is really good? Because when you're promoting a product on Udemy, whether it's an affiliate offer from maybe ClickBank, or you have an independent offer you're promoting, or you're promoting your own products, a coaching program, whatever you're promoting, if you buy from someone that other people are making sales with, chances are you're probably gonna make some sales with them as well. And again, there's some other criteria points that we wanna keep in mind. You can also see right here, okay, this is the rating. So this person has had 681 positive and 10 negative. Okay, you wanna also keep that in mind. Now also on the Find Sellers tab, I usually save a criteria right here that helps filter. Okay, and again, I'm gonna dive more into this a little bit later in the video. But what you wanna do is go through, and let's say for example, we wanna purchase from this Eric, okay? We wanna purchase a solo ad. What I'm gonna do right now is actually break down the different information on their page, how do you read it, and how do you actually start placing your first solo ad? So on this person's page, again, you can see the positive rating, 533, 49% of people that have bought from this person have gotten a sale, 18% of people that bought from him bought it again, okay, which is very good. 5 hours, this is what it usually takes. So when you place an order, which I'll share how to do in a second, this is the average time he takes to actually approve your order. Now, when you purchase, you may not always get approved, okay? So you wanna wait to see if they accept the order. Usually you will get accepted. The only time you won't is if maybe they've promoted that offer. If you're promoting a certain affiliate offer, that vendor, that person has promoted that to their list a lot and it's exhausted it, and they know you probably won't make sales, so you may rate them negatively. So then they won't accept your offer. But in most cases, over, you know, over a year of using Udemy ads specifically in my experience, you know, virtually all of them have approved me. Now, once you go down here, this is where you can actually create your ad, okay, your solo ad. Now, I love solo ads because there's not a lot of moving pieces. You don't have to do a lot of testing. There's no images. Basically, what you do is you just edit this right here. Okay, this is the subject line of your email. So when you, if you imagine in Gmail, okay, you probably have a Gmail account or Yahoo. When you get an email, first off, all you can see is that first subject line, that first piece of text. That's the headline. That's what this is. Okay, so you want to put something in there. Also, you want to write a good email. This is the actual body of the email. Okay, and when you create this, to actually, you know, put in whatever link you want to send it to, what you would do is just highlight one of the pieces of text, click this little paper clip, and then you'd put in your affiliate link or your website. Okay, so I'll do google.com just to give you an example and see if it becomes clickable. Okay, now I highly recommend, as a bonus tip, you want to send people to a capture page. This is a page that the person puts their email in, and now you can follow up through emails. Because if you just send them directly to an affiliate sales page or, you know, a coaching sales page, chances are most people are not gonna buy instantly and you're missing out and you're not gonna make the most money. What you wanna realize is most people buy after 7 to 10 exposures, 7 to 10 follow-ups, so you wanna send them to a capture page. Now, if you don't have a capture page or you don't have an affiliate program to promote with solo ads, I highly recommend you check out the free video at the first link in the description. That's my number one recommended affiliate program. Gives you done for you capture pages, follow-up emails, all that good stuff. You can check that out. But essentially, this is how to do it. Now, if you're just getting started and you don't know how to write a good email, you can just do link only and then just put in your affiliate link or the link you want to have people sent to right here. Okay, so you can just do the link only. Now, these different options here allow you to filter the traffic that you're gonna get. Okay, so base filter is pretty good. If you have an offer that's only for mobile devices, you know, it's only gonna work on a smartphone or something like that, you can do only mobile. Now, it will increase the total price, which you can see right here. Okay, but that's an option, right? Only mobile. Only top tier. Okay, so top tier basically means that the traffic is coming from more wealthier countries, okay? Countries like United States, Canada, New Zealand, Australia, countries where most of the people have more money that they can actually buy products. Now, you want to have as much top tier traffic as possible. Now, if you go down, a lot of times, you know, these sellers will list how much top tier traffic they have. So this person has 90% top tier traffic anyway. So I personally normally don't choose only top tier because it actually adds on quite a bit of money. And usually it's mostly top tier traffic anyway. And also the prime filter. Okay, so the prime filter is an added filter that Udemy can add on to your order. The prime filter, again, it's not necessary, but you can actually add that. And again, like it says, you know, it claims that it increases the quality up to 34%. I normally don't do the prime filter, and I've had great results without it. Again, you can test it out. But once you do that, this is the next thing. Okay, so it says visitors, right? This is where you choose how many visitors you actually want, how many clicks. Okay, now, like I said, this person has 64 cents per visitor per click. So that's what you're paying. Okay, so you can start here, you know, 100 visitors, $67. He accepts all the way up to 1,000 visitors. Okay, $643. Now you can see the date right here. Now, if you want to delay the run, okay, you can actually choose a different date. So if I want to run in 4 days at the time of recording this, I can change that. Again, you can edit this at any time. Now, just as a bonus tip, I highly recommend when you first purchase from someone, okay, like this Eric guy. Now, if I'm just starting purchasing from this guy, I don't know if his traffic is going to convert with my specific offer. So I don't want to come in here and just purchase, you know, 1,000 visitors. You know, you may think, oh, 1,000 clicks, you know, that's a ton of traffic. Well, again, if it's not converting, it's not good to actually purchase. So I recommend usually around 300 visitors is the sweet spot. 100 visitors isn't usually enough clicks to be able to tell if your capture page is converting with this traffic, if the offer is converting. But if you have about 300 visitors, okay, that's a good sample size. That's a good amount of data to actually tell, like, is this person right here converting with the offer that I'm actually promoting, okay? And if they are converting, then you can actually come back and you can purchase more. Okay, you can start to scale up, and you can see that, you know, 18% of people who purchase from them come back and purchase more. So that's when you want, what you want to keep in mind. You can also message, okay, this person, so I can do this, and I can actually send. Okay, so you can see I've actually purchased from this person before. They asked me how the run went. And I can ask them questions, okay? I can say, hey, you know, I see you are, you know, running traffic. I was just wondering, like, do you think my offer will work with your traffic? Okay, because again, they don't want negative ratings, because negative ratings harms their business. So they're gonna be honest with you. You can actually send them a link to your affiliate offer, to your sales page, to your capture page. And you can say, hey, you know, I'm really interested in running a solo ad with you. Do you think this offer, do you think this sales page, do you think this capture page will work and convert with your traffic? And if they say no, you know, thank them and just move on, right? You don't want to run traffic to someone that, you know, isn't going to convert, but, you know, they may say, you know, yes, and then you could run it with, you know, their traffic. So now what I want to share with you, because you've understood what are the important tabs, how the platform works. Again, it's very simple, right? You're just going to mainly go to the find sellers. And now you've even learned how to run your first solo ad on Udemy. What I want to cover in this last part of the video is the exact criteria I use when I actually choose a person. Okay, so this is very, very important. And let's dive in right now. Okay, so now I have a document open of the exact criteria, and I'll actually include this criteria in the YouTube description below this video so you can just, you know, use this. Now, two of these, okay, these two right here, you can actually set the filter in the Find Sellers tab up here. Okay, so that's for that part. The second part, or the third criteria point right here, I actually do manually go through, because this is very, very important. And again, this whole process takes just a few minutes to actually decide on who to purchase from. So the first one, 30% or more of people who bought from them in the past reported getting sales. Okay, this is very important. So basically right here, got sales. Okay, you can edit how many percent. Again, 30% or more is very, very good, okay? Because again, that means that people in the past, when they buy from them, they'll tell you to me, did they get a sale from them or did they not? And you want at least 30% of the people, because again, when you purchase from one of these people, if 30%, okay, or 50%, okay, you can see like this person right here has 53% of buyers or of, you know, people that bought from them reporting sales. So chances are you'll make a ton of sales as well. Now, once you have that, the next part I like is 300 plus positive ratings with very little to no negative ratings. So you can go up here, go to ratings, and you can edit this, okay? Now you can do more, you know, 500, and you can even go here up to like 50, but the amount of sellers, okay, are gonna go down. And some of the, you know, people that fit these criteria are very busy with a lot of other people ordering from them. So I like to keep it, you know, at the minimum that's good, so to speak, okay? So 300 plus ratings, again, that's good. And I want to share with you real quick, if I do edit, I do 400 plus, now it's 24 sellers, okay? So it's gonna, you know, dwindle these amount of people. But all these people here are fitting that criteria. And the last thing I do is I open up the people's profile that fit the first two pieces of criteria. And now I look for three people that comment, okay, under that vendor, three people that have actually purchased traffic from that vendor and have commented within the last 30 to 60 days that they got a sale, okay? Because if you just use this piece of criteria, that's 30% or more of people that have bought total, okay? So what you wanna actually do is you want to find recent people that have reported sales because you know that their traffic is good now, okay? So what you can do is you can actually open their profile in a new tab, scroll all the way down, okay? And what you can do is you can go to these comments, show more ratings, and now these people, okay, have recently commented. So this is April 19th. At the time of recording this, it's April 20th. So this is a day ago. So now what I'm gonna do is go through these people's comments, people that have actually purchased, and see within 30 to 60 days ago, did three people report getting a sale, okay? So let's do this, right? Great opt-in rate with sales as well. So that's one person. We need two more, okay? Lots of opt-ins and did get a few sales too. Okay, that's two people. So within, you know, a few days ago, got sales, okay? That's three people. So what I would do is I would purchase from this person, okay? Because again, they fit the 30% or more, 300 positive ratings with very little to no negative ratings. Now, he does have two negative ratings, but because he has 2,006 positive, you know, odds are he may get a few negative. This is an incredible ratio. And again, somebody commented, three people within the last 30, 60 days. So what I would do is I would come in, I'd purchase 300 visitors to his, you know, with his traffic to whatever link, whatever capture page I'm actually promoting. And I would wait. Okay, I would wait about a week. I'd look at the data. Did this person give me good opt-in rate with the capture page? Did he give me sales? Okay, if so, if I made a sale from this person, what I would do is I'd come back and I would just purchase more. Okay, I would reinvest my profit into more traffic with this person because again, you know it's converting. So I hope you got a tremendous amount of value on this Udemy Solo Ads training for 2021. If you got value and you never want to miss out on my latest step-by-step training videos, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification. I'm posting weekly videos and you do not want to miss out on them. And last but not least, if you don't have a good converting product that you're actually promoting or you don't have capture pages, be sure to watch that free video at the first link in my description. It's going to give you an overview of my number one recommended affiliate program out of 5 years full-time online. I really think you're going to love that. Anyway, my friend, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you on my next training.